Now, let's listen to our most respected Mr. D. Sivanandan, IPS Ex-Commissioner, Mumbai Police, in the Fireside Chat with Dr. Deepak Kumar Sahu, Chief Editor, VAR India. Mr. D. Sivanandan is a highly regarded IPS officer with an illustrious career spanning over 36 years. After earning a postgraduate degree in economics, he joined the IPS in 1976 and retired as the Director General of Police of Maharashtra State Police in 2011. He has held several senior positions in the Intelligence Bureau, Central Bureau of Investigation and Mumbai Crime Branch. He has also served as Commissioner of Police of Nagpur, Thane City and Mumbai.
What is your viewpoints over the increasing high-tech crimes in the country?
You're talking about cyber crimes, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you know, all the future crimes are going to be cyber crimes only. And this was known to us from 1990s, late 1990s. And that's why in Mumbai Police, we began a cyber crime police station and also cyber crime lab and various other facilities all over the country. Later it followed. But then with the growing internet facility, with the growing cyber facility, with the growing everything depending upon internet and cyber, automatically, when all other things are growing, crime also has to increase. So a stage has come where people don't have to do any other crime through any other means. They can do all the crimes through cyber technology only. For example, a cyber murder is possible, a cyber dacoity is possible, cyber looting is possible, cyber rape is possible. If all that is being happening in a very regular way, cyber assumes very, very an important role in our life. If we want to punish any youngster, just remove his internet connectivity for half an hour and see how they will be jumping up and down. So that is the extent to which the internet and cyber activity has started occupying our lives, and it's most important. Maybe you don't supply oxygen to people, they will still suffer and be there, but you stop internet and see what happens to them. So in my opinion, the cyber crime has to increase because of the internet activity and the facilities and the growth of science and technology. And side by side, also the growth of poverty. For example, because of COVID, earlier, if 200 million Indians were hungry because food was not available or purchasing power was not there with them, today 800 million Indians are hungry because they don't have jobs. All this COVID pandemic and all that has removed the jobs from the companies and others, and people are jobless. Obviously, when people are suffering from poverty, property crime has to go up. And cyber crime is the most important property crime, because in this crime, you don't have to visit the crime spot. In all other, for example, a chain snatch, say snatching or a bank robbery, you have to be present there. But whereas in cyber robbery or cyber bank crime, bank related cyber crime, you don't have to be present. You can do robbing a bank sitting in Mumbai, you can rob a bank of Bangladesh and take the money in London or in Manila or in Rome. So it's very difficult for anyone to catch these people. So that is why all the future crimes are going to be cyber crimes only. We have to be ready for facing the growing cyber crime. In a recent lecture, even our national security advisor, Shri Ajit Doval, mentioned in recent times, the cyber crimes increased by 500%. That's it. So be ready.
Okay. If the police department introduces the e-learning or e-policing as part of the training to tackle cyber crime, how will be the impact on the crime rate?
You know, they have already introduced this computer training and various things in a small way in all the training programs. In my opinion, even constables and various others have to be taught compulsorily all about this cyber matter, because as I mentioned earlier, 1 minute before I mentioned, all the future crimes will be cyber related. Either a mobile or a laptop or a computer will be used for all the crimes. So obviously the police has to be ready. So in my opinion, not only officers have to be trained, all the constables upwards have to be trained in the usage of cyber and in the detection and prevention of crime using the cyber instruments. So it is a must. Like today, a child of 6 months, You give an iPad, how it will do like this and see all the photographs and take a selfie and whatnot, whatnot. Children are being born with smartphones today. Maybe from the stomach only they will bring a smartphone. If that is the kind of situation, police is an integral part of the society. They have to upgrade themselves, both software and hardware. Police department should have the best of software and the police department should have the best of hardware. Obviously, we cannot afford to hire the cyber experts like you. We have to have all policemen and officers good in handling in all this hardware and software. That's my take. Wow. As I said, it is all CCTV based. It is all laptop based, all smartphone based. All crimes we are handling today are cyber related. So police has to equip themselves. There is no choice. There is no escape. Police cannot say, "Hum ye nahi karenge." Aisa bolne ko chance hi nahi hai.
Wonderful, sir. Wonderful. Fine. Local police station doesn't investigate cybercrime. How the police department is equipping the lower rank police response will make
cyber crimes are registered in the Mumbai. As far as Mumbai is concerned, all Mumbai police stations do register cybercrime and they do investigate. So, ab jo bol rahe hain, it is not perhaps true of Mumbai. I don't know, you are talking about which city. Even though we have a special cybercrime police station in Mumbai, there are cybercrime trained people in all police stations. They do register cases. Today only I helped somebody in a police station in Mumbai. They have registered, they have investigated, they have collected all the evidence. They are going to charge sheet that man, an important officer in a private limited company. So that way police stations are registering cybercrime. No more special police stations like women police station, cyber police stations. As I told you earlier, every constable, every officer has to handle the cyber crime and the cyber equipment.
Wonderful, sir. Way to approach for crime registration.
Tell me again.
Way to approach for crime registration.
All crimes are registered in the police stations only under section 154 CRPC. All police stations are equipped to register. And the crime, even if it happens elsewhere, we can register in some other place and then the police is supposed to transfer the crime to the appropriate police station with a zero number. You know about Sushant Singh Rajput's case, where the Mumbai police was investigating a suicide, Patna police registered some other case, and all that happened. So process is simple. You can register a case in the police station under 154 CRPC.
Wonderful, sir. Great. My last would be, what is your take on exposure to social media leading to a cybercrime? Can you throw some light?
You know, all social media users have to be very, very careful about their exposure. When one is intelligent and beautiful looking, of course, in the social media, they all look very beautiful and all friends appreciate. What amount of exposure, what amount of things you are letting others know? Today, any criminal can come approach somebody to be for on the dating website or any other website and take them through the garden path. Lots of educated people are taken through the garden path by way of varieties of scam, online scam, like job offer is there, or a lottery scam is there, or my friend is in distress. You know, you hack somebody's email and send contact to all their contacts. Here, boy, my dear friend, I am in a difficulty, send me 10,000 rupees. So all these things are happening. So in the social media, all your activities have to be absolutely appropriate. And you have to have also a privacy setting in the social media. Every time somebody is upgrading their mobile or anything, they don't know that the privacy setting has been set aside. You have to go and set up the privacy setting once again. Who has access to my social media has to be almost every day. All youngsters have to see what is their privacy setup. All their photographs go to where and who is watching them. What kind of photographs are they putting up? What kind of personal information they are giving? For example, if a person is giving away, standing in front of the car and his car or her car and taking a picture and posting it in social media, from the registration of the car, we can go to the website and get the address, car owner, all details can be built up. If your mobile number is given, from there you can go into varieties of things and build up an entire background of a person. If somebody is going on a holiday, say, I am going to Shimla for the next 7 days. So So when you come back, your house may be empty. Somebody could come and vacate the whole house and go away. So in the social media, people have to be absolutely careful as to what kind of exposure they are giving and who are all having access to that. And privacy setting has to be seen every day. Who are all allowed to watch your activities in the social media? This is very, very must. And you know, morphing, changing, adding, deleting, all that can happen to your pictures. And people can see that their pictures which are there can be misused by people by taking it away and changing, altering these things. So my advice to all your listeners is use strong passwords for preventing your being a victim of a cyber crime. And the password should be not less than 10 digits with lot of combination of capital letter, small letter, number or asterisk marks or something like that. So it takes years for anyone to hack into a password which is 10 digits or 11 or 12 digits. If you have a simple password, by using any software, people can break into your computer. Second is, don't anytime share your password to anybody, because people are very fond of sharing. My advice to your viewers is, computers cannot be broken. It will take years for anybody to hack into a computer, but hacking by getting your password through your employee or an ex-employee getting into your computer is the easiest for anybody to do. So be careful about your password. So also when you go to shopping, be careful as to whether you are shopping on the genuine online shopping centers or anybody who is faking. Also, when people come into your company system and when they drive away the money, which is supposed to come from one country to another country, there also you have to look for those websites. For example, lottery and various things are all coming in the name of Coca-Cola or Pepsi, Reader's Digest. Job opportunities are all being given in the fake websites of TCS, Infosys, Wipro, RBI and sites like that. So can be, for example, recently, you know, Nidhi Razdan, the famous TV newsreader of NDTV, was taken through a garden path by somebody saying that I'm offering you a professor's job in the Harvard University. I think people think Nidhi Razdan to be a very intelligent person. At least I consider her to be a very intelligent person. But how she could was taken? Every website, whatever she checked, was absolutely looking appropriate. This can happen to a young lady who is intelligent, educated. It can happen to anybody, particularly senior citizens are vulnerable. So my request is, please tell all your viewers that your password has to be 10 or 12 digits and your security settings has to be proper and your antivirus setting has to be updated. Kindly pay for it. Pay for all your antivirus settings. Everything is free. The last advice is, we are all fond of taking anything which is coming free. Any attachment looking good or sexy or any offer which is coming free, we immediately download it without even reading. We say, I agree, and we download it. Don't be greedy. Nothing comes free. No free lunch at all in our life. So please do not click anything which comes with an attachment coming from an unknown person and also offering some very attractive things. It can be sex, it can be nude picture, or it can be anything, or money. So be careful about anything. Nothing comes free in life. We have to work very, very hard. So before clicking into all these things, all of you have to be very, very, very clear. So this is my advice to your viewers. Be very strong and change your password and don't pass on your password to everybody. Password is not for passing on to others. And don't leave your computers open and be available for others to go and manipulate. Shut down your computer before going to the washroom. So these are all my some simple advice to people. So that my take is, prevention is better than cure. A lot of people come to me and ask for help getting money lost and how to recover it and all. Once this money is lost, for example, the Bank of Bangladesh, which was taken away $83 million from the Federal Reserve of New York, that has not been detected since last 5 years. And the money lost is $83 million. If that is not detected, your loss and my loss is not going to be detected by anybody. Cyber crime is the most difficult to detect, and international agencies are not cooperating with each other as much as they do. And cyber patrolling on the cyber highway is the most difficult for any police force to do. So with all these difficulties, you and me and your viewers have to be very, very careful in preventing the cyber crime rather than asking the police to detect it. Unfortunately, the robbers, the criminals, are three steps ahead of the law enforcement agency, and the law enforcement agency, namely your police, is always three steps behind, because their resource crunch is there. They can't buy the best computers, they can't buy the best software, so they are always at a loss to catch up with the criminals. So kindly spread the word, prevention is better than cure, and my advice I have given you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir, for joining the session and enlightening us about the Maharashtra government.